Captain Navy Festus Zakaria. Ladies and gentlemen, this quay is a perfect venue from which to offer you all a warm naval welcome, because it's emblematic of the transition between the land and the sea. Your Excellency, we have been looking forward to your visit, and your presence here today is a great source of motivation for us, if only for the fact that the most important service a government can provide its people is to keep them alive and free. As members of the armed forces, we understand that the freedom we enjoy today must never be taken for granted. We also understand that war and peace are opposite sides of the same coin. Therefore, freedom is not free. It must be fought for to achieve and fought for to keep. As constitutional defenders, we are the guarantors of that freedom. And we are extremely grateful that you have voted, Your Excellency, to accord due importance to defense programs. The Navy is today 12 years old, and over that period, we've made remarkable progress in developing the Navy as a viable component of both the Namibian Defense Force and national maritime power. Presently, we are engaged in three distinct activities, which is the recruitment of personnel, the development of onshore facilities, and the acquisition of naval assets. We are therefore formed up here today in anticipation of your guidance as to how to proceed with these programs for the next 10 years. Your Excellency, once more, and on behalf of the men and women of the Namibian Navy, please welcome. With that, I would like to invite the Honorable Minister of Defense to introduce His Excellency. Thank you.
Chief of the Defense Force. Defense Force, and in particular today, such as this one, that we do not only celebrate their coming, but also remind ourselves of the Namibian Defense Force have an important responsibility of ensuring their defense and protection of the Namibians' territorial integrity and the sovereignty. In particular, the Namibian Navy has the direct responsibility of ensuring that 1,365 kilometers of Namibian coastline is protected. Furthermore, the Namibian Navy has to remain vigilant in order to make sure that the guards against all types of maritime threats, including piracy, maritime terrorism, drug, weapons, and human trafficking, not only at sea, but also in all navigable waters of the Republic of Namibia. By honoring us with this important visit, our President, who is the Commanding Chief of the Namibian Defense Force, is always encouraging and reminding all of us to remain true to our assigned duties and responsibilities. Therefore, I'm honored to invite Comrade President to address the parade. Comrade President.
Thank you, Director of Ceremonies, Honorable Tonaya Takola, Minister of and Women of our Namibian Navy. I have had the pleasure to visit with the three service headquarters of our defense force, namely the Army, which I visited at Grootfontein, the Air Force, which I visited at Karibep, and now today I'm rounding up my schedule of visits with the Navy. After my visit to the Army, Air Force and Navy, I can truly say that Namibia is in safe hands. I have been highly impressed with the professionalism, commitment, passion, and technical proficiency displayed by men and women of our armed forces. You truly deserve to get recognition for what you are doing in defense of our sovereignty. To paraphrase Robin Hayes, I would like to state that those who served and those who continue to serve in our Army, Air Force, and Navy took an oath to uphold and protect the Constitution of Namibia against all enemies, foreign and domestic, and we can never forget the importance of their commitment to our nation. No wonder that the Director of Ceremonies quoted the preamble of our Constitution. Today's visit has allowed me to meet the leadership of our Navy and familiarize myself with its core activities. After what I have seen, I can say that there is no doubting our Navy's capacity and capability of conducting successful maritime operations. Of course, we understand we are a small nation militarily, but there is an advantage that comes with that, as it allows us to be highly mobile and agile and adaptable. You have often heard me referring to the fact that Namibia is a child of international solidarity, friend to all, enemy to none. It is our people's ability to live in peaceful coexistence with our neighbors, as well as countries far afield, that has allowed us to continue receiving support from friendly nations even after our independence. Many countries continue to support Namibia's developmental efforts, including the support to military. With regards to supporting our Navy, which was commissioned in 2004, countries such as Republic of South Africa and the Federative Republic of Brazil, among others, have played a significant role in the areas of training, skills transfer, supply of equipment, and naval vessels. Furthermore, these countries help us in planning and developing of key infrastructure. We thank these nations for their continued solidarity. I would like to urge the men and women of our Navy to continue emanating a high level of professional contact and ensure more transparent systems of accountability, keeping in mind the imperative of national security as well as the spirit of our Constitution. I'm aware that our Navy has a daunting task of securing our 1,572 kilometers of coastline as well as rivers. This task is further complicated by the fact that Namibia's waters and coastal area is blessed with an abundance of natural resources such as fish and minerals, which if left unprotected could be illegally exploited by various criminal syndicates. In this regard, the government will explore all means to support the efforts of our armed forces, including supporting the Navy in carrying out its mission of conducting naval operations in defense of the sovereignty of the Republic of Namibia and its citizens and national interests. I am aware that in today's technologically complex military environment, there is an array of equipment that our Navy requires in order to be on par with the rest of our region's militaries. However, I urge that we should all be cognizant of the realities we face. We have declared all-out war on poverty and therefore need to ensure that we prioritize our sacred or scarce resources appropriately. I therefore urge you to do more with less, but where we can, we will always support your efforts. And I can tell you, I was briefed and your chief has put some demands in a very diplomatic and friendly way. To date, our Navy has already achieved a great deal from the establishment of the Maritime Wing on September 11, 1998, to the commissioning of the Navy, which I mentioned earlier. This was followed up by the establishment of the Marine Corps and Navy Training School in 2005 and 2009, respectively. I'm pleased to note that the Marine Corps will be commissioned this year. In addition to the Navy's achievements in institutional development, great progress has also been made in the area of personnel development, where a large number of officers have been trained and deployed. This includes infrastructure development and the acquisition of various types of equipment. Only thing I realized and pointed out to the chief is that when we were sitting in a briefing room, I was told there are only 20 women in the high hierarchy of the officers. But I was quickly told that they are working very hard to rectify that situation, and I've accepted that. I also told them that I cannot be recruited at this age because I was told all of you can swim and I cannot swim. So therefore, maybe some of us, including some female members, may have difficulty to swim, but I don't believe that. So I promise that in tandem with our policies of 50-50, that they will try their level best to recruit and train some more female officers. I am pleased to note that the Marine Corps will be commissioned this year. In addition to Navy's achievements in institutional development, great progress has been made